Records. I just mentioned the records. Here's what we've got. The old records were negative 21 in Flint, negative 12 in Saginaw. The new ones are at least negative 23 and at least negative 15, because those could change. The official recordings from the National Weather Service are sometimes between the reading periods that we record here at the station, so could be a little lower. But at this point, these are the actual numbers we're going to be watching for. Current temperatures, though, we've been in the negatives all through the morning. Wind chills basically at the actual air temperature, but a little cooler in some spots, including up to the north. Standish, up towards West Branch, those have just been downright frigid at negative 40. Current temperatures for the highs today, 13 for the southern counties, what we're watching for. Wind chills still really cold because we've got a breeze we're going to be watching for out of the south-southwest. Same thing for the Tri-Cities and the Thumb, 13 degrees for your high all the way through. Western counties going to watch for a little bit of flurry activity before we get to the end of the day, and that's when we're going to watch for more snow. I'll get to that in a second, though. 12 degrees for your high across the northern counties. Same thing, negative 15 to negative 5 for the wind chills with that light breeze. Now for tonight, 9 degrees for your low. Temps increasing, actually, from after dinner time, which is when we reach this, all the way through the overnight period, and we're watching for that snow. Speaking of snow, here's what we're watching for. This is when it's going to start to move right on into our area as we head towards about 2 o'clock this afternoon. Watching for flurries as we head past that point to about dinner time, and then 8 o'clock is when it's really starting to be heavy on top of us. And we're going to watch for, overnight until noon tomorrow, about 1 to 2 inches of snowfall across the area, mainly everywhere I-69 northward. So that includes our entire broadcast area. As we get into tomorrow morning, it still remains there, and as we head towards noon, that's when it calms down. So there's that point. Now, as we get into tomorrow afternoon and into Sunday morning, there's that next round that's going to be on top of us. That'll bring about another inch possible. And as we go into the rest of the weekend, into the beginning of next week, we freeze again. So we get some relief tomorrow, Kristen, but we have the cold temperatures return once again for next week.